So I would like to, before we actually start, to do a moment of centering, and would like to ask if anyone wants to guide us in that. If not, I can do it. All right, so I'll do it. Let's take a few deep breaths. And then settle in our breath as it is. Notice the lifting of the shoulders, if that's the case. What parts of the body are being moved by the in-breath and the out-breath. Notice your feet on the ground and how it's sustained and the weight. If you're standing up, sitting, just notice the weight of your body. Sustain either in the chair or by the earth if you're standing up like I am. I invite you to just to follow from the feet up from the legs all the way to the sit bones, the spine, and up, all the way to the shoulder area. And there we can stay a few seconds, maybe decompressing, moving, rolling the shoulders, however we want to decompress any tension. Maybe moving the neck to one side and the other, rolling the neck, however you feel, gently to decompress any tension. Some of you are at the end of your day. Some of us are in the morning. And then continue up to the top of the head and above, as if connecting to the sky, to the universe, the space above. And if you like, we can also lift up your arms in recognition of the space above, however you want. And with that, recognizing the above space and the earth, connecting both with the lower space of our body and the upper space of our body. And then slowly fluttering your eyes, maybe looking first to the sides, to the space, and then gently when you're ready. Also connect with our space on the screen. And with everyone on the screen looking at each one's face, this community that gathers here on a weekly basis. Just look at our spaces, our faces. And bring it in as if we were in the same room. And today, I'm bringing to us something that is special to me, that is connected with the practice that I do, that I've been doing for a few years. And that is Biodanza. My community, my main community is in Portugal, and I started in 2014 with the pandemic. Before the pandemic, I was away from my community, but the pandemic brought them back, and we did it online as best as we could. And so I'm going to share the video from my facilitator in Portugal. Video is about one class that is happening at Biodanza. So my invitation for us is to scribe as we watch, and I'm going to share it once, but it is spoken in Portuguese, so you might have some difficulties with the lettering because they're very small. And if that's the case, just write on the chat letting me know that you need to listen to it twice. It's a 9-minute video, and if we need, we can play it twice.
Este lugar onde coisas acontecem, onde sentimentos são sentidos, onde danças são dançadas, onde as expressões mais profundas vêm de dentro, né?
A biodança é um sistema de desenvolvimento humano que nos ajuda, semana após semana, a transformar as nossas vidas. Através de exercícios específicos, através da música, mas músicas deflagradoras de emoção, através da dança. A dança com movimento pleno de sentido. Às vezes parece-me impossível o quanto as pessoas transformam as suas vidas enquanto dançam. Eu vejo isso acontecer ao longo das aulas. E estes são alguns dos seus testemunhos.
O que me vem à cabeça é que a biodança é uma espécie de um lugar. Mas não é um lugar físico. É um lugar onde nós nos escapamos, nós saímos daquilo que é a nossa vivência cotidiana, nossa vivência ordinária, por assim dizer. Para mim é um lugar de vivências extraordinárias.
O
vou deixando as minhas funções, os meus papéis, os papéis que eu desempenho no dia-a-dia, em que vou despindo essas peles acumuladas. É um espaço e um tempo em que eu me permito ser eu, exatamente como sou, livre de ser quem sou.
Eu experimento situações da minha vida real em tipo laboratório que depois ou antes já vivi ou vou viver.
Às aulas chegam muitos alunos, todos diferentes, com a sua bagagem, histórias e memórias de uma vida inteira e também com os seus problemas. Aqueles que têm a coragem de ficar, de olhar de frente para aquilo que é a sua vida, de reescrever a sua história. E aí dá-se um processo incrível de renascimento.
Posso dizer que a biodanza fez-me reencontrar de uma forma mais concreta a minha criança interior, a minha criança que eu fui, e com essa criança também as dores dessa criança que tem transportado comigo dentro de mim.
Qualificação, aceitação, valorização, tudo aquilo que é da ordem do reconhecimento, do olhar do outro sobre ti, mas um olhar de quem? Um olhar verdadeiro, um olhar amoroso. Epa, mas tinha que ficar aqui a tarde toda te falar de coisas da minha infância que me faltaram e que eu gostaria mesmo que lá tivessem estado, mas que se não fosse ter passado por elas através da biodança, eu não teria passado por elas.
É como se eu tivesse tomado a decisão, a dada altura na minha vida, de que não queria sentir. E ao não sentir, não sofria. Mas também, ao não sentir, não vivia.
E viver neste estado é horrível, não é? Era uma apatia, e esta apatia queria dizer que eu não me lembrava, que eu já não existia enquanto pessoa.
Aos poucos, na pior, escrevi a minha história. E vi que não era preciso ser tão duro, tão doloroso, tão... E aos poucos encontrei paz, mais paz, mais paz. Até chegar a estar em paz com o outro.
Apesar da vida depois nos apresentar estes obstáculos todos, a biodança vai resgatar essa felicidade dentro de nós. Eu gosto disso.
ter medo disso, abraçar a criança interior, abraçá-la com os dois braços.
O meu valor é inquestionável e eu não dependo do que me fizeram no passado. Eu é que decido hoje do que eu quero fazer na minha vida.
E a biodança é isto mesmo. É um convite, um impulso, um chamamento. E semana após semana, através da dança, vamos transformando as nossas vidas. Seja qual for o teu momento existencial, agarra a tua vida nas tuas mãos e transforma-te na melhor versão de ti mesmo.
Thank you, Denise.
We do this. Mm-hmm. Everybody put their drawings like this. Let me just get here to do this screenshot. Right. Okay. Now let me share with you Can you see it?
Mm-hmm. So now the invitation is for us to look at this mosaic and share what comes up. Either individually or the one that stands out to me, that what do I see, what I feel, what I sense, or comparing them, however you want to do. And who wants to start, can start.
So if I look at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, at all 7, then I see in the middle this moving person, the one from Rebecca, in yellow and magenta, let's say, red. So a very moving person, also at the top with Biodanza, the one from Denise. And I see then smaller lines and also a lot of color. And the person in the middle just goes where the word pass, or I don't know the spelling, but peace. So that's what I see when I look at the whole thing.
I feel movement when I look at the whole mosaic. And I sense a huge energy emerging from yellow, because all the drawings, all the scribing, whatever colors each one chose, everyone used yellow, calls my attention specifically Cecile's drawing with those blurred colors. And then it seems to me that there's an eye that transforms into the head of a person with arms and legs as a Hindi goddess.
I think it's very different to look at them all together. And with my glasses and without my glasses. Without my glasses, I cannot see much, but I see colors. And I still see that fire dancer in the center, that it's yours, Rebecca. And Cecile's drawing is like what I see without my glasses, and I think that's funny. It's like an animal looking. I see something like this with a hat. I don't know if you can see it. And I would like to see more in the contrast of the color. I would like to see more of Rowena's than mine, because as we did it in pencil, the colors, and it's not clear what we did compared to the contrast. And I like to see the dance of all of them, but in these two in the center is stronger, the feeling of dancing. And in Mary Jo's on the right, I'm not sure people are dancing. I know they are moving. And I see the yellow, the energy.
I feel a little bit frustrated because I can't see all drawings like I would like to see them. I would like to dive into each one and see the details. So I'm a little bit frustrated only to see them so little, but I see curved lines and I feel movement. And in all of them, except Angel's one, because I can't see very, very clearly, but I see human shapes, bodies, and I see colors everywhere. And I feel life and a feeling of connection. And I would like to see them more deeply. And thank you very much, because it's interesting. I would like to see particularly the one that are not so clear for me, Angel, Rebecca, Andrea, and Rowena ones. Thank you.
I definitely see the people dancing in four of the pictures, lots of movement, lots of energy. And in Rowena's and Angel's, I almost, and somewhat Cecile's, I almost get footsteps, that these are the kind of things that we're moving towards. So Rowena, kind of when they were talking about the animals in Cecile's, I see a bunny rabbit in yours. I don't know why, but there's a bunny rabbit hopping across your page. Yeah. So I really think the colors, the pinks, the bright colors, the movement, it was definitely a free flowing experience. But I definitely feel the energy and I sense a lot of happiness in the pictures.
So I see a lot of what everybody else has said. In some of these, I feel like there's something that's releasing, like up in Cecile's. I see like the pink head coming up and the pink head coming down, and that there's these black lines, and it makes me feel as though there's something being released out of that body. Similarly, in Denise's, you know, there's the fluid line perhaps of hair and the fluidness, but there's something coming out or going in. And so in all of these, there's like an angelic spirit that's floating And I really appreciate that. And I also changed mine because as soon as I saw it, I realized I wanted the background to be green. So if you click into the chat on my image, you'll see what it, I think I actually intended it to be. And thank you, Rowena. I'm very familiar with, you know, these type of dance movements. I've never heard of this particular one before, so it's really beautiful, but you gave me an experience of feeling like I was back in those classes, both the type that I teach, but also other dance experiences that are considered ecstatic experiences where you really connect with source at a profound place with others. And that's like the most intimate place you could be, kind of outside of the sexual experience with another person, is in that ecstatic state of being. So thank you.
When I looked at the whole mosaic, I was drawn to the one in the middle and representing the movement. And there is a aliveness in that, like it's representing each one of the other ones and the video, because there's this, the body is moving freely and the hairs are going flowing. And so the whole body is let go and surrendered. And that's one of the things that Biodanza allows us to do. And each one has such special messages. I mean, portraying the message. I see in Mary Jo the globe and the international energy. I see in the knees, the bodies in different movements, and the hearts, and a place of extraordinary experiences. And I could go on and on about each one. Overall, I really like the colors, the how it landed on each one of us. And that's what excites me to see this.
I feel also that it's very interesting that if we look at the mosaic, as you said, when we have all together, and then I tried to share what this makes without seeing details, just to see all of them. It's very different than to look more deeply in only one of them. But it's very interesting to do it this way, because with the dance also, it was just everybody is moving, and it makes also a shared feeling or something with the whole social body in the room. And it was also difficult for me to paint or to draw, because I would have liked to move.
Mm-hmm.
So it was very complicated for me, that this feeling of wanting to move, I have to put it in a small piece of paper. So I tried to move like this with the different colors. But so when it is embodied in the body, or if it is a felt feeling that I try to put in a picture, that's interesting to see that is different channels somehow.
Until, can you show yours again?
Yeah.
So we can see it with the tail.
Mm. So it was also something going, as somebody said already, that this peaceful feeling just goes, is moving.
When I first saw this, I actually felt pain, because I'm reading like the rib cage or the ribs.
Oh, yes. I thought it was the ribs also.
Yeah, like a spine and the ribs wrapping around. And so like it's almost like the cry, the you know, the red, the scar, whatever, but that it's like, again, like something that's opening and releasing into that, like the hope of healing and the hope for peace. So it's a very complex image for me. But now that I see the music and kind of how the pink and the red, the fleshiness kind of evaporates a little bit into the green, yellow, kind of it's being held, you know, and it makes me feel like I can breathe through those ribs. Thank you.
Thank you, Rebecca, for your observation. And that's what I like about sharing what I see, what I feel, what I sense. Because in fact, having that sense that it is the chest or the rib cage, it probably was not in your drawing, but actually it portrays some of what goes on in our body. Because we open up when we do the Biodanza. Mm-hmm. And so the red part and the things that probably are disturbing to us, actually, in this image, now that I saw it closer, it can be there. And I had not seen it, but by Rebecca sharing it, it kind of brought me to that connection that Biodanza brings. Some people may cry throughout the whole class. Some people, so it's not linear. So that piece, that image that Angel brought to us actually portrays a combination of both. There's peace, there's the yellow, and there's the red that kind of sometimes tears us apart to clear the things that is within us and liberate us and allow us to be fully who we are. And that's why I really like this methodology, Biodanza, because gradually and little by little, that's what happens to our body. We open up as we dance and we allow ourselves to be fully. And thank you, Angel, for portraying it even unknowingly. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Rowena.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.